Super High Impact, released in 1991 in the arcade by Midway and ported over to the Super NES and the Sega Genesis in 1993 by Acclaim and Beam Software. This game right here is a precursor to games such as NFL Blitz or even Mutant League Football, if you were a Sega Genesis owner back in the day. The concept behind this game was actually created by Ed Boon, who would be later known for the critically acclaimed Mortal Kombat series. According to this video, I only have the Super NES version. And as I said before, there is a Sega Genesis version available. The question I gotta ask you guys is this: are you ready for some football, ladies and gentlemen? Well, let's go ahead and see how this game holds up today.
Super High Impact!
It's time to get on the gridiron and show the defending team what you're made of. It's non-stop arcade action football at its finest. Forget having penalties, timeouts, or even a douchebag referee that would call random flags on certain plays. This is all about making football a fun sport to play.
The controls in this game are well mapped out. In the original arcade version, there was only one button to pass and or kick the ball. You don't want to have these overly complicated control schemes like you were to find in Madden, then Super High Impact is simple enough for you to control.
While you and a friend are playing this game, or if you're playing alone, if you're playing against a computer, you can select whatever team you want to play against each other. The only problem, there is no other modes in this game. I can hear the Madden fanboys raging on about this. But since it's an arcade style game, it's nothing much to matter about anyway. Now, aside from its normal on the gridiron gameplay, there are subtle times in the game where a random fight will take place after one of the opposing players tackle down each other. You better be on guard, folks.
Somebody get a body bag.
So far, the design is just as what we expect to see on a home console. It's really nothing special, and the best I can really sum it up in a nutshell is that the arcade version is a bit more dynamic. I really don't have much to comment on there, and I cannot complain on this matter either. Personally, I have a lot to talk about the sound. I really cannot help but to say that the voiceovers in this game were done by real actors, for one thing, and the cliches are just downright hilarious. From what I was able to tell, I would probably assume that the announcer in the game is voiced by Ray Clay, the same person who would be the public voice announcer for the Chicago Bulls basketball team from the NBA. Why do I make that assumption, you may ask? Well, take a listen to the game start sequence, and you'll probably see what I mean.
And now, it's Super High Impact!
On the gridiron, well, you know things are about to get ugly. If you're on the offensive team, when you're about to start running your play, you will often hear the defensive team talking major crap at you, saying such cliches like, "You mama's boy," or "You're going down." Just take a listen right here.
Wicked hit!
Cut, you mama's boy!
Move! 51! Hey!
Another huge plus is that if you played and or owned the Super NES version, the title screen opening music sounds extremely familiar. If most of you don't know already, it's actually a rendition of the song Sirius from the Alan Parsons Project. Take a listen to both to compare, and you'll see what I mean.
Pretty obvious Super High Impact for the Super Nintendo and Genesis is a damn good sports game, in my book, even though there are things that are lacking, such as a tournament mode. But since this is an arcade game, who really cares? It also makes a definitive proof that you do not need the NFL license to make a great football-based video game. Yes, I know there are some Madden fanboys that are going to get on me for that. And if you like arcade-style football-based video games, or sports games in general, then I suggest you add this game to your video game collection. Go out there, buy yourself a Super NES or Genesis, and do get this game. I recommend it. Have some friends come over and host your own Super Bowl party playing this game, too. So now, this is Kid Thunder signing off, and I'm going to play this game to celebrate the end of football season. Take care, ladies and gentlemen.
Your face! 47! 51!
Hi! Oh, my knees!
Eat this! Fight! Somebody get